Hello students, how are you? Okay, let's start study. Today I'm going to teach you another chapter of stars, that is The Enemy. The Enemy by Paul S. Buck. It is from Vistas. Let's study about the writer. Pearl Sidney Stickle Buck, 1892-1973, was an American writer and novelist. She had a Chinese name, Sai Zhuanzu, as she spent her childhood in China. Being the daughter of missionaries, she was awarded the Pulitzer Prize in 1932 and the Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 1938. Before studying the characters, let me discuss with you the theme of the chapter. In the chapter, The Enemy, the author stresses on the fact that humanity requires one to overcome prejudice and hatred, especially against one's enemies. Through this chapter, the author conveys the message that humanism transcends all man-made prejudice and barriers. Let's go through the characters now. The main character of the chapter is Dr. Sadao Hoki. Who is Sadao Hoki? A Japanese doctor trained by Americans. So another important character is Sadao's father, much concerned about his son's education. A true patriot, Hana, the wife of Dr. Sadao, who met him in America. They became friends there and got married in Japan. Tom, another important character around whom the story revolves actually, the enemy. He is the enemy. Tom, an American prisoner of war, a soldier of US Navy. Another important character, the old general. A sick Japanese army general needed an operation and he used to trust only Dr. Sadao. An officer, a messenger of the general, gardener, these are the servant in the house of Hana and Dr. Sadao. Gardener, an old gardener in the house of Dr. Sadao. Yumi, Hana's maid servant, spelling need a correction here, Y-U-M-I. The cook, an old cook in the house of Dr. Sadao. Place, the house of Dr. Sadao. That was built on a narrow beach near the sea in Japan. Let's start the introduction. The story highlights how a Japanese doctor saves the life of an American prisoner of war and rises above narrow national prejudice. He risks his honor, career, position, and life by sheltering a war prisoner of the enemy camp and saving his life. The author has beautifully portrayed the conflict in the doctor's mind as a private individual and as a citizen with a sense of national loyalty. Here is the theme I have already discussed with you. The enemy gives the message. The chapter Enemy gives us a simple message that humanism transcends all man-made prejudice and barriers. Dr. Sadao upholds the ethics of medical profession in treating an enemy. The story is actually a great lesson of peace, love, sympathy, fellow feelings and humanism. Let's start with the summary. Dr. Sadao Hoki's house was built on the Japanese coast. It was actually set upon rocks above a narrow beach. Surrounded by pine trees, means his house was surrounded by the pine trees, which you can consider as the boundary wall. Sadao's father was a very serious and traditional man who never played or joked with Dr. Sadao. He had a deep concern. His only concern was that his child should get better education. So his main concern was the education of Sadao. So for this purpose, Sadao had been sent to America at the age of 22 to learn all that could be learned of surgery and medicine there. When he returned, he was 30 years old. He became famous not only as a surgeon but as a scientist also. So his father became very happy that his child fulfilled his dreams. It was the time of the World War now. Japan was at war with America. Dr. Sadao had not been sent abroad with the troops. It is an important question. Why Dr. Sadao had not been sent abroad with the troops? And the reason was, the old general was under medical treatment and he might need an operation. So Dr. Sadao was being kept in Japan always by the general. Another reason was that he was investigating a medicine which could render the wound completely without leaving any mark. So this was the second reason that why he was not sent with the troops. Dr. Sadao had met Hana in America. Who was Hana? Hana was also a student of Japan, but he met to Dr. Sadao in America. But he had waited until he was sure that she was Japanese before deciding to marry her. Sadao fell in love with her, but he waited because he knew that his father was an Orthodox Japanese and he would never allow him to get married with an American girl. So he just waited until he became sure that she was Japanese. His father would never have approved of her otherwise. Sadao met her at an American professor's house. How did they meet? They met at the house of an American professor. They came home to Japan. Their marriage had been arranged in the old Japanese way, according to his father's wishes. They were a happy couple. So now the story starts actually. One night, what had happened? Sadao and Hana were enjoying the view of the sea from their veranda. At this moment, both of them saw something black coming out of the mist. What was that? It was actually a man. He staggered a few steps. Then the cold mist hit him again. Hana and Sadao leaned over the railing of the veranda to have a closer look. They saw a man crawling on his hands and knees as he was not able to walk. So he was just crawling. Then he fell down on his face and lay there. He was wounded and lay motionless on the sand. He was a white man. On the right side of his lower back, Sadao saw that a gun wound had reopened. He was bleeding. Now, being a doctor, he just packed the wound with the sea moss. The man cried. When the doctor applied that moss over his injury, the man cried but didn't wake up. They read the faint letters on his cap. It said US Navy. Means this person belongs to the Navy of America. The American was a prisoner of war actually. Sadao knew that giving shelter to the enemy would get them into trouble. He faced a dilemma. He was torn between his moral duty as a doctor, which urged him, which said him, which requested him to save the dying man, and his national duty, which required handing him over to the army as a patriot. Now he needed to decide immediately. Both Hana and Sadao finally decided to take the man home as he was in need of urgent medical attention. They decided that they should tell the servants also about his presence in the house, and they will let all the servants know that after treating him, they are going to surrender this man to the Japanese army. But the servants frightened at what their master had just told them. They thought that their master should not heal the wound of the white man. Even Yumi refused to wash a white man and returned to her work. Hana herself when why Yumi refused? Hana, because the man needed an operation, but he was so dirty. So first he needed to be washed, and Hana requested Yumi to clean him, but Yumi refused to wash that man. Then Hana herself had to wash the prisoner's chest and face with the steaming hot water carefully. Now her anger was ebbing. Earlier she was getting angry that why Dr. Sadao needed to operate him. Sadao was ready to operate. He was completely absorbed in his work. He told Hana that she would need to give him anesthetic. The bullet was still there. He had already lost much blood. Hana couldn't bear the sight and ran out of the room. She had never seen an operation, but Sadao did not realize that. Sadao was busy with his work, but she came with a bottle and some cotton in her hand out. Then, with a very clean and precise incision, the bullet was taken out. The man quivered but was still unconscious. He only muttered a few words in English. Sadao declared that the man would live in spite of his sufferings. After 2 or 3 days, the young man woke up. He was too weak. His blue eyes were terrified when he thought where he was. Hana came and consoled him not to be afraid. She comforted him that he would soon be strong. On the third day, Dr. Sadao came and examined his wound. Tom asked what they were going to do with him. At this time, Sadao looked at him. He was just looking 17 years old. For a moment, Sadao didn't answer. Tom was a prisoner of war and should have been handed over to the police. So he didn't want to develop any sort of relationship or sympathy for him. So he just kept mum. The servants felt that they could not stay if Sadao hit the white man, that white man, anymore in the house. So they became rebellion. People would think that they liked Americans. The servants grew daily more and more watchful. Sadao wanted the prisoner to get up on his feet. He should practice it every day till he gained strength. The man thanked the doctor for having saved his life. The doctor cautioned him not to thank him so early. The last stitches had been pulled out now. The young man would be all right within a fortnight, but the seventh day, important quote is there, the seventh day, two different things happened. First, the servants decided to leave together and they left when Hana paid them according to their work. On the same day, a messenger in official uniform came to Sadao's house. He asked Dr. Sadao to come to the palace at once as the old general was in pain. But Hana could not realize why the messenger was there. She just thought that might the servants had told the police officers about the presence of that American prisoner, and the messenger has come here to arrest him. So Hana breathed a sigh of relief when she came to know that the general was in pain. So Sadao was being called. When Sadao came to say goodbye, she revealed her fear. She had thought that they had come to arrest him. Sadao promised to get rid of that man for her sake. Now he could not bear the tension. He just wanted to make his wife free from the stress. So Sadao told the entire episode to the general. The general knew that Sadao was indispensable to him. He cannot leave him. He never trusted other Japanese surgeons. So the general promised Sadao that nothing would happen to him. The general then made a plan to get rid of the American soldier. He wanted American sailor to be assassinated. He told Sadao that his private assassins were very competent and would also remove the dead body. Sadao thought that this plan would be the best for his family. After that meeting, Sadao spent 3 restless nights waiting for the assassins, but they didn't come. Finally, the torture became too much for him to bear. Then he planned to get rid of the enemy himself. The next morning, he went to the guest room. He thought of putting his boat on the shore that night with food and extra clothing in it. The American might be able to row to that little island not far from the coast. Nobody lived on that island. He gave all the necessary instructions to Tom and also gave him his own flashlight. He told Tom that he should flash the light 2 times if he needed something. Once if everything was fine. Once. He must do this only when the sun had dropped under the horizon. He added that Tom could find many fish to eat, but he should eat them raw, lest the fire would be seen. Even Hana didn't know about this plan. Sadao had told Tom to wait for a Korean ship. After that, Sadao went to the general and operated him. When general was in his proper senses, he informed him that the American man had escaped. The general informed Sadao that he forgot about the prisoner as he was unwell. He told Sadao not to leak this information to anybody and also assured him that he would get reward for that. But for Sadao, his reward was something else. The definition of the reward was something else. Sadao got his reward how? When he didn't receive any signal, no one was there on the island. It meant that the prisoner had gone. Now you must be thinking, why he left the prisoner? The prisoner had gone safely. Sadao remembered that he had great difficulty in finding a place to live in America because he was Japanese. The Americans were full of prejudice. The white people were repulsive. It was a relief to be openly at war with them at last. Then he remembered the haggard face of the prisoner, white and repulsive. Strange, he thought. I wonder why I could not kill him. Now students, do all the NCERT questions. Stay home, save lives, be healthy.